this lesson, I want to extend our current car rig with a few more controls. Especially, I want to create controls for this axis here to control this movement here. And I also want to control the banking of my car if we are in a curve or something. To do this, first of all, we should take a look at the axis of our car. So I'll click here on the body. And we see that our axis is somehow rotated, and this can cause some issues. So go on in axis mode and just set this one to zero, that it's totally resetted at 0, 0, 0, and disable axis mode again. So now we know that we want to do something with this axis. And of course, also with the banking. To do this, we should at first create our controllers. So I will create a rectangle, set it to X, Z, that it's flat, and scale it down to maybe 200 centimeters. And then we will lift it upwards, type in the Y position 150, that it's exactly above our car. Then we will create a null object, call this one banking, set the null display from dot to, for example, star, also orientation XZ and Y position to 150. And we could even make it a little bit bigger, maybe 20 centimeters, something like this. And now select our null object and the rectangle and set the use color on, and maybe we change it to a bright green that we can see it very good. So this should be our controller, so we can move the star around and control the banking of our car. So first of all, we make the null object a child of our rectangle. So the local coordinates of our banking is now set to 0, 0, 0, because it uses the coordinate system of the parent as the root. And now we can start with our rig. So I will select the null object. And the first thing I want to do is I want to restrict certain axis of this object. So I don't want to be able to move it in this direction. So right click, Cinema 4D Tax, Protection, and here we set it from lock to limit, and now you see that we can type in different values. So the Y axis will be limited from 0 to 0, so we can't move it in this direction. And in here we type in the distances to our rectangle. So our rectangle has the size of 200 centimeters on each edge here. So I will click on the protection tag and set the limit X from -100 to 100, and the same for the Z axis. And if I now start to move my star around, you see that I can move in here, but the rectangle is something like a cage or like a limitation. So we can only move in this rectangle, and we can't move in the Y direction. So this is very nice, how I like it. And I will also create a protection tag on our rectangle and just set it to lock, because we don't want to be able to move it by hand. And now I will make the rectangle a child of our master null object. So when we move the car around, this control will also move around with it. So let's open up our expressor again. And because we're extending our setup now, I want to give us a better overview. So we will zoom out a little bit, select all nodes, right click, convert to X group. So now we know that this X group is for the rotation of the tires. I just select the X group, click on basic, and type in rotation of the tires. And maybe we make this one maybe a blue color. So we know that this part of our espresso setup is just for the rotation of the tires. We can make it also a little bit bigger. and move our stuff in here. So we have a good overview. So let's start a new node graph over here. So what I basically want to do is I want to take this star, and let's first of all take a look at this axis. When I move it forward, I want my car to lean forward, and if I move it back, I want my car to lean back. So this is just a simple range mapper thing. So we will take the banking. And the important axis for us is the Z axis. You see down here, it goes from minus 100 to plus 100. So I will create an output port, coordinates, position, Z. And it's important that you choose here position and not global position, because we need the coordinate system which takes the parent object as the root. So Z, and we need a range mapper. Connect it to the range mapper. And now we should take a look at our car, how much we want it to rotate. So I will take the body. Take a look from the side view. And let's see how many degrees we can rotate forward. So I would say something like this, maybe. Something like this. So this is minus 2 degrees, maybe. Minus 2. That sounds good. And the other way would look like this, maybe. So more shouldn't be possible. Yeah, this looks cool. So 3. 3 and minus 2 should be my two points which I want to control. So if we take our null object and place it here, so at minus 100, it should be 3 degrees, and if we put it to the tip here to plus 100, it should be minus 2 degrees. So let's click on the range mapper, parameters, and let's define our input lower and input upper. The input lower should be minus 100, and the input upper should be 100. Input lower should be 3 degrees, and input upper should be minus 2 degrees. And of course, we need to set the output range to degrees. Sorry, again, 3 and minus 2. So it has to look like this. And now we can bring in our body. So the thing that we basically want to rotate, bring in the body. And we need, let me check this first, we need the pitch axis, as we see down here. So the pitch axis changes right now. So I will create an input port, coordinates, rotation, pitch, and simply connect this to our range mapper. So let's take a look at our car, take the star and slide it around, and you see that we have now a very nice control over the banking of our car. So we can do this with the second axis also. So now we need the X position of our null object of the controller. Position X. We just copy our range mapper. Take a look at the values. We'll bring this window down. So now we don't need 3 degrees and 2 degrees. So I'll take a look at the body. And let's see how much we want to rotate it. Maybe something like this should be fine. So this is 2.8 degrees. So let's do this. I will click on the range mapper. And where is... okay, so when it's totally on the left, we want minus 2.8 degrees. And when our star is on the right side, we want 2.8 degrees. And I will create an input port for our banking axis. Connect this one also. Now we have pretty good controls over the banking of our car. Very intuitive. So now we can slide our star around in our control here and make the car follow our animation. So in this lesson you learned how you can build a custom control for the banking of our car. And in the next lesson we will create a second control for the steering of our front wheels and build a little animation with it.